everybody. How is this Saturday night going? See, I'm all dressed up for my Saturday night with you guys. Hi, Ashish Benival. Hi, Shubham. You've seen my web series? Which one? Did you like it? Maulik, hello. Varun, thank you. Hi, Shiv. Hello, Swapnil. How is everybody doing? What is the weekend plan? I mean, I know we are all quarantined, but that doesn't mean we have to be all sad and down. I mean, we can do fun stuff, right? Vic Singh. Yes, though, that's my bookshelf, one of my bookshelf. I'm quite a voracious reader, so yeah. Rajat, thank you. Which one? Pratibimb? Anubhav, studying. Okay, do you have exams coming up? Maulik, I like you too. Thank you. A sort of self-development. That's one of the best things we all can do, you know. Hello, Dheeraj, Anubhav, MBBS. Wow. We do need more good doctors. Shubham, I'm your crush. Okay, thank you. I am Mr. Perfect. Shout out. Whoop, whoop. Shout out enough. Are you in Mirzapur second part? I'm Prateek. Yes, I am. Truly Bengali. Good to see you too. Faisal, when is Mirzapur? Faisal, I don't know when is Mirzapur 2 coming. Trust me, this is like Bhagwan se poochna padega. Ab to Mirzapur 2 kab aa raha hai? Humne apna kaam kar diya. Kuldeep, you're from Mumbai, okay? Yogendra, Gujarat mein sab kuch, I hope sab theek hai. Christy, thank you. I know I haven't worn a sari for a long time. I mean, I keep thinking I will, but motivation nahi mil rahi hai sari pehenne ke liye. Bahut zyada tam jam hai. IG Yuvraj, your Janat. Aww, oh, sweet. Archan, hello. Nandu. When is, अरे यार अभी तो बोला मुझे नहीं पता है मिर्जापुर 2 के बारे में. सुधामा, वॉचिंग मिर्जापुर. मिर्जापुर 1? ओके, आई होप यू लाइक इट. आई एम प्रतीक. व्हाट डू आई ईट, प्लीज शेयर. आई ईट लाइक, आई ईट नॉर्मल स्टफ, प्रोटीन मोस्टली. आई ट्राई एंड अवॉइड कार्ब्स, सो या. Santosh, hello. Liked your role in Hostages, thank you. Thank you. Mirzapur 2 release date answering. Yaar, pata nahi hai mujhe Mirzapur 2, pagal ho jaungi main. Mujhe mere DM mein itte sare messages hai na Mirzapur 2 ke bare mein. Sudhama, yes, episode 2, season 1. Okay. Kavya! Hello, Kavya. I called you, Kavya. You didn't reply, as usual. I am Mr. Perfect. Do I feel proud to be a Bengali? Of course I feel proud. I mean, I feel proud that I'm an Indian. I feel proud that I'm Bengali. ভিকি, কলকাতা কবে ফেরার প্ল্যান আছে? এখন তো কোথাও যাওয়ার কোনো প্ল্যান নেই, এখন তো বাড়িতে লকডাউন কোয়ারেন্টিন। ম্যাম মুসাফির জি, ম্যাম হুঁ মির্জাপুর টু মে। হ্যাঁ কাব্যা, মানে দেখা নেই অভি তক, বাট আই উইল সি অ্যান্ড রিপ্লাই। ট্রু বেঙ্গলি, সবাই ভালো আছে, আমি আশা করি তোমরাও ভালো আছো। Okay, so the thing is that I'm going to add Steen, and she's a beautiful orator, an MC, a beautiful actor, and today I want to chit-chat with her. Hi, Chrissy!
Hello! Hi! What's up?
Hi! Firstly, say hi to everybody, and I was just introducing you. So please tell my viewers what you do, and start with that. Let's start with that.
Okay, so hello everyone. I'm Christine Zedek, and this is the first time I'm doing being on Instagram as a chat. Anamsha has been a dear friend, and it's just I'm excited to just be on this on this chat. So Ooh. Nice to see you. And you're looking lovely. You're looking like a little cutie pie. Hello, all the fans out there, you know, all your fans, a big hello, and I hope everyone's doing great and everyone's safe at home, and I hope they're making the most of their time during this quarantine period.
Hi, Shurjeet. Okay, so Chrissy, tell us, I call her Chrissy, her full name is Christine Zedek. So Chrissy, tell us what actually do you do apart from being an amazing actor and an MC? What else do you do?
Okay, so I'm an actor, anchor, MC, voicing artist. I'm also now transitioning to be, I'm a lifestyle influencer.
What is that? Hold on. What is a lifestyle influencer? I want to know. Educate me.
Okay, so basically, I'm following this whole concept of conscious living, where I'm going more towards, you know, being conscious about what we do from our thoughts. To you know, everything from internal, what we think, what we eat, how we treat each other, how we love and respect each other. I'm so you know, I want to spread that awareness to people, because this is the time where we need to not only respect Mother Nature, we need to respect each other, and it's just about making conscious decisions in life, whether it's food we eat or how we treat each other. I mean, it's there's so many factors. So I'm starting something called Mission Communication. It's an online course where it's about the joy of effective communication, and everything boils down to how you communicate with yourself, how you communicate externally to people, and the whole thing, you know, how you get yourself out there, how you literally present yourself. So I'm very excited about this baby of mine, and I really, it's my mission. It really is my mission to help millions of people out there to just heal and have effective communication. I think half the problems will be solved, you know, in all kinds of relationships, including relationship with you. So that's the main thing.
I think the biggest thing is the relationship with ourselves. I think I wish we were taught this in school. You know, I keep thinking about this, and I think like so many years would be more beautiful, I'd say, if this was taught in school.
And that's what, you know, I so agree with you on that, because we've grown up in a different programming, right? And conditioning. Where no one has talked about it. Now it's a new wave. Now people are vocal. And I know we both have had amazing conversations over the years.
Yeah.
Where, you know, it's been a struggle to find ourselves and just say, okay, who are we? What do we think? And no one's had these discussions, right, before. So the more we talk about all these things, the more you share your story, the more I share my story, we're going to be helping millions of people out there sharing their stories, and it'll help them open up. You know, it's such a...
Hey,
it's so important.
Clint is there. He's saying hi
Hey,
and thank you for this
hi,
session.
Clint. Yo,
Clinty!
dude, what's up? Oh my gosh, Clint is a freaking
He'll keep saying
wire. Okay,
shizzle
Charles is. He says hello. He's saying hi to us.
nizzle. Hi,
Another friend of mine is here. Hi, Poonam. Okay, so I don't know
Charan
where.
Preet. Yeah,
Hello,
we are safe, Charanpreet and Samrat. Hello, Samrat. So many people.
my sister Angie is here.
Hi, Angie. How are you?
Oh, this is so nice. It's so good to see everybody.
Yeah,
Oh,
it's like, you
wow.
know, we are locked down, but we are together.
Hey, hi. Yeah, that's true. And I have to say, there are a few people, it's sad. I just saw a few comments that there was somebody who's a little disrespectful. And I have to say that, even to some people who feel it's okay to disrespect people and just say what they want to say. I mean, first of all, my heart goes out to people like that because I know that they probably come from a very hurtful place, and that's why they feel okay to be disrespectful to people and women, especially behind the camera online. And I just want to say I wish you so much healing because trolling people is actually an act of cowardice. So just wishing them a lot of love and a lot of healing because they need it more than anybody else.
Oh, trust
So
me, I get it on a daily basis,
think
so.
twice before people. Yeah, I mean, being nasty doesn't get anybody anywhere. I don't get it. I don't get it. Why are
True.
people so yeah? I mean, and I
So,
always tell people, that we are ambassadors of our family. So what we
yeah.
are, what we portray, I mean, it all boils down to that. And so if you show love, it shows that's where you come from. So yeah.
So yes, so one question I asked Clint and he's like, boring, I'm not going to answer. So, but I'll ask you, what are you doing during the quarantine? What is your daily routine like?
Oh my God, I'm busy. I am busy like crazy. I'm having so much of fun, during this time, and it's really amazing. So I wake up and I actually have a morning routine. I spend 2 hours with myself. Literally, I start my day in prayer, and then I read, I meditate. Oh my God. And I look forward to my mornings because it's so much of fun. Then after my mornings, then starts my day, my routine. Believe it or not, I have been learning so much. This has been the most amazing time for me to learn. I've been attending webinars and, like I'm learning art online, learning business online. So I don't know how my time flies. And I'm working on my course, Mission Communication, which I'm going to be very soon. So it takes up a lot of my time, but I
Wow, how is that turning out? Did you burn anything yet? Because I have burnt a lot of stuff. So
It's been fun. It's been really fun. I mean, I've been experimenting a lot. So I made the Oreo cake, which is the most simple ABC way to make a cake. So I said, let me try. It actually works. These things that they talk about work. And I'm so excited. I said, yay. So I actually been trying a lot of stuff. And, I've had the freedom to cook even before. But something about this quarantine, especially seeing people's posts on food, got me hungry. It got me so hungry. I was like, I think you and I want to make that. So it's been fun. So you tell me, what about you? I want to know about you. What have you been up to? And you are like, I've seen your yoga posts. I've seen you. And I'm like, this girl, from the time I've known you, I remember you balancing on one leg and posing and doing all that. And I'm like, how is she like this? Your exercise regime is unbelievable.
For all the people out there, for the longest time, I've tried to take Christine to my yoga sessions and she went once for my spinning sessions. And she's like, oh my God,
Oh.
Angie, Stop it. I'm going. Oh,
I don't get it. Ask me to dance, I will dance the night away. But exercising is a different category. So for me, exercising like dancing is equal to equivalent to exercising. Yeah.
Yeah. I think I have, like, I was in the beginning, it was pretty intense. I was getting a little down and under, and because you're just like at home and it was playing up, but I think I found my groove. I started like doing a lot of yoga and meditation. I did that Deepak Chopra, the 21 Days of Abundance that I did. Yes. So I started and I saw an uplift in my mood and everything like changed. I think it's all our perception and how we are manifesting it. But now even I don't find time to do a lot of things. I'm like all the time, either I'm reading, either I'm doing yoga. But my main thing is I have set goals. I like it like that in life. I need goals and I need to chase them. So I have these little physical goals and all that. So that I'm doing and it's been fun.
Wow. Angie says yoga नहीं होगा.
Angie, yoga से ही होगा.
Yoga सही होगा. Believe it or not, I have to tell you this, and I think you're going to be really proud of me. I have a friend, she sits in Hyderabad and she comes on live and she teaches me yoga.
Oh,
And
wow. That's
I started this recently. So, and at the end of the day, I'm like, you know what? I can just put off that camera any minute, but I don't, because she says, wrong posture, put your back straight, stand up, stretch more, don't come.
Wow.
Okay, Bob.
That's really cool. That's an
Yeah.
achievement.
So I can't
Yeah,
believe I'm doing yoga online. So yeah,
please
it's
tell your
funny.
friend thank you from my side. I'm like, I've tried for years, so yeah.
No, I tend to take a few breaks, but yeah, she's somehow, this quarantine has helped me say, realign and say, okay, let me do some yoga. It's good, at least because I feel I know the benefits of yoga, and you've always you have told me how I should, always be a part of it. But now when I do it, I can actually feel how good it is for my skin, for my body, for my stretches, for my, the back, the posture. Oh my God. So, hats off to you. I don't know how you used to do all those balancing acts, but
I've
amazing.
had
You're
a little bit
amazing.
of practice, I'd say, but
Yeah.
it's really good to see your body change and your mind getting, and it's pretty tough, but yeah, it's good. Let's take a few.
Yeah, say
Sorry.
hello to everyone. Yeah. No, I was just
Yeah,
going to
yeah.
say, I wonder what your fans are doing. Do your fans follow you? And because of you, do they follow yoga? Is what I want to know. So, what are
I
your
hope
fans
so,
all
people.
about?
I mean, I have had people tell me that please take yoga sessions, yoga videos, and I'm like, I don't really like giving out any sort of knowledge which is half-baked, and I don't think I'm an expert enough to teach people. But it's
Yeah.
really sweet of them.
Yeah.
Abir is
So
saying,
Andy says you're really talented. Abir says you women seem to be having a lot of fun, but no clue what the context is. Well, Abhi, there is actually no context. It's just about, coming in, chatting up, saying hello, and just talking about, times during this time, the quarantine time, where, what are we doing to make it really amazing? And I think it's all about, how productive are we during this time? So yes, sorry, you.
yeah, and Abir, it's we always don't need a context, right? We too are people who like laughing, who like dancing, who like doing atrangi stuff. So we are just trying to entertain you while we do all that madness. So yeah.
Yeah. I mean, does everything always have to have a context? I mean, why can't we just say hello? Honestly, this is the first time I'm doing a conversation like this. So for me, this is like, wow, here I am live, and I'm getting to see some of, my friends, and my friends are actually saying a lot of, they're complimenting you a lot. So I call Anansha Anna. Okay, so for
Yeah.
those of you, she's Anansha, but I call her Anna Pyar Se. So I'm getting a lot of people, who's just saying, who just complimenting you, in fact. They're
No,
like,
thank
you are
you.
really, really awesome, and you're a beautiful woman, and you're talented. So it's good to see that.
Thank you, thank you. Yeah, so the thing is, I think if Clint is watching, I'm going to steal some of his ideas from his session. So one of the ideas that stuck by me through that session was I will say something in Bangla, okay? And you have to guess it. And you can say something in Malu, and I have to guess it, okay? But simple stuff so that it's fun at the same time, okay?
I can try to get you. I don't know any words. Okay, चलो, we will try. ठीक है, चलो.
So start. The first one is তোমাকে সুন্দর লাগছে.
Ah, so that was simple. So you
Yeah.
want me to translate it, right?
Yes, in English or yeah, in
So
English.
you're saying you are looking beautiful, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. I know very little, but let me try this. Okay. I'm going to say, Enike Vellum Venum.
Oh, okay. Charles is saying if she only knew Malayalam.
Trying. I know. I hardly know Malayalam, but okay. But you
Okay.
can understand. What did I ask? What did I say? Enike Vellum Venum. Enike.
No clue. This was difficult. Enike
Enike
Vellum. Okay, did
Vellum
you have a
Venum.
do you want a drink? Did you have a drink? You want some chai?
I said I wouldn't know what drink is in Malayalam, but I asked, but I said I want water. Enikku
Ah,
enikku vellum venum.
Enike Vellum
Enikku
Venum.
vellum venum. Huh.
Vellum, vellum,
Family's
vellum,
telling me to shut up. My family's telling me to just because they think I'm terrible at this.
vellum. Okay. So what else? What other games do you have in your mind? So Christine is a big board game buff. Like my board game initiation with her.
I love board games. I love it. Oh my God. And I can just have a party just for board games. So, and I know how much
Yeah.
we have played. Oh my gosh.
And we wanted to win so badly and so much we did. It was so much fun.
Yeah, it was really crazy fun. Angie says like it's a vellum. She's saying venom, venom, manicure, venom, venom. Mad. Okay, so there are a lot of people. Arey, arey, Hindustan bhai is like so mean. He's. I mean, guys, show some respect. Come on.
Hey
Chalo.
guys, how was your day, guys? The Indian feed. I am Dishant 28 says I love Christine.
Ah, thank you.
Angie says Tani is Tamil. Okay.
Board games. When you get bored, you play board games. Yes, Pulo Begum. That's my friend, Poonam. That's so cute. That's
Oh,
funny.
hi.
Hi. Yeah, I
Board
know. Thank you,
game.
Indian Feed, for acknowledging that. Yeah, there are people who are getting abusive, and I just want to point them out and say, I think you all should all go to whoever's abusing here. Just go to their go to whatever their what do you call it? The handle is,
Handle.
and give them a lot of love. Give them a lot of love. They need love. So I think every time I see somebody being a troll, I say they need love.
Indian feed says you look like Kajal. Who's Kajal? She looks
Kajal,
like Christine.
I
She
look
does
like
not look like
Christine, and whoever
Kajal.
else you think, they all look like me. I look like me. Like me. So tell me, let's work on expressions, okay? Since we are actors, okay, and I think we'll do one expression round. So okay, let's do the okay. Yeah, try. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, not bad.
You should take screenshots.
Okay, I don't know. Okay, never mind. This is going nowhere. I know you sing really well. So maybe we should have a song. We should go do it or something. Whoa, what? You have an amazing voice.
Yeah, okay, after some time. You can't make me do all the work. Then I'll make you dance, okay? Think about that.
I do love dancing, but I need music for that. So.
Okay, next session, oh, maybe you can keep a system around so that we can do that also. That'd be really fun.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, yeah. Do you have music around? Do you have anything?
Yeah,
do you
I have television, yeah. I have a television,
okay.
Yeah. Yeah,
okay.
I can
so time.
YouTube.
Oh, Angie wants you to sing a Bengali song.
Oh, I don't remember any Bengali song. It's been
oh,
so
somebody's
long.
Somebody's saying to sing In Bihar Ho Gayi. Somebody's asking to sing that.
Okay. Okay, I'll sing.
I love that. I love, oh, Amitabh Bachchan. I love Amitabh Bachchan.
I know.
I love that song. I'm sure.
I know.
Come on, let's
I
do
don't
this.
Remember the words. Okay. Intezaar ho gayi, intezaar ki.
Ta-da-da, ta-da-da, ta-da-da.
Aina ha kuch khabar mere yaar ki. Ye hame hai yaki. Bewafa wo nahi phir wada ho jayi intezaar ki.
I love it. You are amazing. My goodness, how talented are you?
So okay, what else games did we play? What? Okay, so let me ask you rapid fire questions and then you can ask me rapid fire questions. That way our fans can know more about each other and we'll take a few questions also at the same time.
Hello, let's do that. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so, okay, it's a rapid fire, Chrissy. So fast. Okay, what's your favorite color?
My favorite color is aqua blue.
What's your favorite food?
South Indian food. I love my Keralaite food. I like my Mallu food. I love it. It's my favorite.
Okay. What's your favorite outfit?
I love jeans and a top. Any day. I'm a jeans girl.
Okay. What's your favorite destination?
My home. I like to visit Dubai. That's where my family is.
Okay.
So
okay.
I love that. And then, of course, the rest of the world is a fun place to visit, but home is where the heart is. Yeah.
True. What's the place that you'd want to visit after the lockdown?
Okay. After the lockdown, I would say, actually, I don't know. I'm so happy sitting in the house. It's not even funny. But yeah, probably I'd like to, yeah, definitely take a flight and go back to Dubai. And see my mom. Yeah.
Tomorrow is Mother's Day.
Yes, tomorrow is Mother's Day. And wishing all, you know, everybody who's online here, please, you know, say, give your love, give all your love to your moms. Make sure you, you know, acknowledge your mothers. Tell them how much they mean to you. Don't take them for granted. Don't expect them. Do something for them, right? For a change. We always... assume our mothers are supposed to do things for us, but I think we should do something. You know, for we should do something.
Ashirvad Verma. So yeah, guys, send us your questions and I can ask Chrissy. Ashirvad Verma wanted to know who's your crush.
My crush or your crush? I think he wants to know
your
about
crush.
You.
It's not my question. It's your questions. Who's
How do
your
you
crush?
Know that? How do you know it's my question and not your question?
Because I already said the rapid fire is for you.
Okay. Okay. All right. Who's my crush? I love Hugh Jackman.
Ah, yes, he's a hottie.
He is like, oh my gosh, I could, like, when I watch his movies, and you know, it's not just about looks. I've been following him, and I can see the fact that he's a really good human being, a family man, and a man of values. So I think that's what really catches my attention, you know. So yeah.
Okay. Next question is, go for it. What were you saying?
Fire for you then. Let's have a rapid fire for you. Okay,
Okay, go for it.
so okay. Let I haven't thought of these questions, but let me think about them now. Okay, so what's your favorite film?
Schindler's List.
Oh, heavy stuff. Okay. Somebody's asking, what's your favorite destination in India?
In India, it got to be
Oh,
Kerala.
I remember when you went there. I remember you had so much of fun. Okay, fantastic. Okay, what's the latest food that you've been introduced to that you like?
Sushi. Sushi,
Yeah. I enjoy sushi too, and it's really, really a very, you know, it's a lovely cuisine. Yeah. Okay, and what's the one skill you want to learn that you haven't learned so far?
I want to pick up a music, like a not a music. I want to pick up a instrument.
Instrument?
I
Yeah.
was
Which
trying to
instrument would it
learn.
be?
I want to do the guitar, but I've taken a few lessons. It looks hard, but let's see.
No, I the first thing about a guitar is you have to make sure you have to make sure you cut your nails really short
Yeah,
to
my
strum.
nails are short, but
Yeah,
still it hurts. It hurts the
okay.
fingers.
So Pulu Begum wants to know, what's the book behind you? I think she's fascinated by the book. So which book are you referring to? Are you talking, that's one is a picture, one is a frame, or is also a
No,
book?
that's also a book. That's a biography of Suchitra Sen. She's a Bengali legend actor. And then
Of
there are
course.
a mixture of a lot of books.
Okay. So Angie says, when you come to Dubai, Amrit will teach you how to play the guitar. This she doesn't have
Okay.
so many people teaching you in Bombay. Okay.
Hi. Is there also or not?
Pulu Begum wants you to pick one book. Pick one book.
Okay.
Oh my goodness. Okay, it's Ulta for us, but huh?
It Ulta?
For us.
But that's how I can.
Oh, that's
It's
Charlie Chaplin, my
Charles.
autobiography.
Yeah,
Oh, Charlie
Charles Chaplin,
Chaplin. Wow,
my
have you read it?
autobiography. Yeah. Oh, I love
Wow.
it.
Wow. I've seen the film, and it was amazing. I love the film. It was amazing. Oof. And Robert Downey, my God, what a
Heartbreaking.
performance. Yeah.
He is amazing, amazing.
Yeah.
And I recently finished this. I don't know if it's Ulta also.
Yeah, it's Ulta. If one is Ulta, all
It's a 5 minute break. Little laugh. Okay. We need a recess of 5 minutes of Chrissy laughter.
sorry. Continue.
Okay, done. Okay.
Continue. Yeah,
That's
yeah, yeah.
Murakami, Men Without Women. I just finished it and it's a very good book.
Wow. Tell me more about it. What is it about? Men without women?
So it's about these stories which it's he loves doing this absurdity. It's on the line. It's not very clear. It's very left to your imagination, and it's
Interesting.
beautiful. I can't really explain unless you read it. But he's one of my favorite authors. You must have heard about Kafka on the show. That's also an amazing book. It blows your mind, and you're like thinking, and yeah, really
Wow.
cool.
Somebody's asking, who do you admire the most? That's Sam Frank.
about who do I admire the most doesn't.
Okay, every time somebody's going to abuse you, I'm going to take their name. So, Muhammad Fahad. Everybody give a lot of love to Muhammad Fahad because he's abusing. And every time somebody's going to abuse, we're going to acknowledge them and give them a lot of love. Because I feel they need it the most. Okay, so only love. And we have to take their names because since they're so openly being so amazing. We should acknowledge them. Okay, so who do you admire the most?
As in, who do I admire the most as in what context?
In any way, in any context. So it could be either an author, it could be an actor, it could be, you know, a political figure, it could be anybody.
So I really look up to, in the West, it would be Meryl Streep, and in India, it would be Smita Patel. These two are like my idols, and I really like their work, and they're amazing women. So,
yeah, that's so true. I mean, you know, just looking at all these, you know, all these personalities out there, and especially the ones who stand up for, you know, a certain. So when you look around them, you're like, they're really changing the world. You know, they're really changing the world, and it's remarkable. So. Yeah, I think that's amazing. One of my favorite women is Sushmita Sen. I love her. I love her. I think she's, you know, at a time where it was very rare to for somebody to be so open and honest about everything. And she dared to be different. So she's my all-time favorite. Yeah.
Okay, so since we both are actors and since we are women and since we are in this time, so tell me one thing, how do you handle adulation and trolling? Because there's a question I've been asked in one of my recent interviews. So I want to know about you. Like, how do you handle it? Like when people are either praising you a lot.
After that, India feed, I'm sorry, I've not been seeing your things, but he's saying, why are you not responding to me? So hello to you. We'd like to acknowledge you. It's just that. Madhuri Dixit. Chandan is here. Hi, Chandan. And yes, Madhuri.
Hi, Chandan.
Yeah, Chandan is here. Hi. So good to see you. Yes, and adopted kids. Shushmita adopted kids. Yes. Okay, yes, she did. Okay, so back to your question. How do you handle adulation versus trolling? So ideally, you know, trolls, usually I ignore them. I mean, this is the first time I'm acknowledging trolls because I really believe they come from a place of hurt and they come from a really dark place where it just shows that they, you know, they're broken people. So if whatever they're reflecting comes from what they've come from. So I look at trolls as people I feel kind of sorry for, but I feel they need the most love, right? That's why I keep saying. Otherwise, honestly, they're so easy to ignore. They're really, they're not worth putting energy. I choose to give energy to things that are positive, that are happy, that are that make me smile.
Right.
It's worth giving putting energy to that. But the minute you see a troll, especially on a live thing like this, I want to pick them up. I want everybody to see them and say, hey, you know, let's it's important that they know that they need to be acknowledged, and they're all looking for attention at the end of the day. Some ask for attention, some ask for attention really negatively. Trolls, I feel, and you know, got to show their face, wow. But if they don't, then lots of healing to all you trolls out there. And adulation, of course, there was for the longest time, I was very shy on accepting compliments for the longest time. And I was very, difficult for me. I didn't know where it was coming from. Are they just saying it because they're superficially saying it? Do they really mean it? Am I really that? No, is it really a word? You know, we're actors. And people just compliment you because they want to be good to you on your face. You don't know where it's coming from. But I've realized it doesn't matter whether it's a troll or whether it's somebody who's complimenting you. It doesn't matter. How do you see yourself? You take everything in the light of, you know, I'm not going to be so much in awe if somebody thinks you're the most beautiful girl on the planet. I'm not going to be so disturbed if somebody says, "Christine, we can't stand your face." It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if what they say. You know, I respect, I value my fans, and I value the love and respect I get. At the end of the day, what matters is what I think of me. If I don't value myself enough, then what's the point, right? So then, the minute I value myself enough, then all these things will come and go. People will come and go. Things will come and go. The hatred will come and go. But that's not going to really disturb my mental peace, or that's not going to take me really high, that's not going to take me really low. So that's what I feel, you know. I don't think we should be ruled by people, you know, all of this, because at the end of the day, are they really your friends? Are they really your family? And who matters to you? It's your friends and family, the people who really matter to you. That matters. You know, how much they mean to you, how what our relationships are, that really matters. Everybody else, you know, today we're gonna, today they're forgotten. So then
So I think even I'm on the same lines. I feel my opinion is on the same lines. So recently, because of my choices of body of work, I had been getting a lot of love and a lot of adulation and a lot of criticism and a lot of judgment. And you know, people think they can talk about me and the way I look and all that, blah 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 blah. But I think recently somebody asked me, and I think with all the meditation and yoga, I'm going to give all the credits to it. I've realized at the end of the day, all that matters is what you feel about yourself when you're looking in the mirror. What do you feel? I was telling Clint the same thing. He was asking me, do you like it if people compliment you? Do you like it if, or do you feel sad if somebody says something? But like you, even I have been very shy with compliments. But then there is, I think today I have achieved that place where neither adulation affects me nor trolling affects me. Like for me, both of that, I don't let it get to my head because I feel that at the end of the day, even family and friends, why? It's only you. I think if you think you're looking a certain way, it's good. If you think you're looking in a, like, I think with age, acceptance has really crept in me, and I'm so thankful and grateful for that because I found it, you know, I found it really difficult to accept myself the way I am, and I would always be critical. But now, I think
And
I'm
you've come a
very
long way.
happy.
I've seen your journey. You have come a long way. And today when I look at you, I'm like, you have embraced yourself for who you are, which is amazing. And I've seen you transform over the years. And rightfully so, we all go through that. We all go through our own journey of self-discovery and figuring out, you know, what we do, like, who are we? Like, what do we stand for? And all of that. So I think it
Chandan
really
is
makes
saying, "What is making you happy?" Chandan, who are you asking that
And just before this, Chandan had written, you know, you girls are bringing in so much beauty into life. So thank you, Chandan. Nice to see you
I
here. Chandan, by
you,
the way, Chandan is a fantabulous actor. He has done amazing work from films to ads to theater. My goodness. So it's good to have a fellow actor with us on board.
And recently I saw one of your work and you were amazing. You're just lit.
He's versatile. I don't know. He's brilliant. Angie Singh Chandan is here. That's what's making us happy. Oh, my friend Gopal is here, the one who teaches me yoga from Hyderabad. Hi.
Congratulations. Finally, you are teaching her yoga. She's doing yoga. I've tried for years. Trust me, it didn't work.
Oh
So, yeah.
yeah. Oh gosh, it's so funny. Yeah, but yeah. So I mean, it's so true. You know, like the very fact that you go through a journey. We all go through a metamorphosis of figuring out who we are and what we are. And at the end of the day, it's all about loving and accepting. And this is something, and not just for women, it's for everybody out there. We're always trying to put our best foot forward, trying to be something we're not. But just be yourselves. I mean, like, I think love yourself, accept yourself, and keep, you know, I think we need to keep working towards improving ourselves. That's one thing. accepting yourself is another thing.
I think
but
you're better with other people. I think you're better with other people once you accept yourself. I think those doors open and you're actually, the more you're conflicted and complicated inside, it actually manifests outside. The more you're easy and you're happy with yourself, the more you are actually happy with others. So, somebody just wrote, we were enjoying that rapid fire. So, should we go back to that rapid fire asking you questions?
Oh God, I don't know. You seem to have a lot of questions up your sleeve. I don't. But, oh gosh, Chandra, PJ.
Okay. Come on, Chrissy. PJ is your thing.
I cracked a few today. I can't even remember. We cracked a few today. I wish I had written them down. But, you know, PJ is something that comes spontaneously. So, it doesn't, you can't think of a PJ. But I came up with one recently, which I posted on my, on my feed. And it was like, I thought it was filled with bad, you know. I couldn't
believe Indian it feed, yes, you can give us questions. We will ask each other. Indian feed is saying wants to.
So I see all these bats in the day and I'm like, oh my God, there's so many bats. And this is the first time I'm seeing so many bats, you know, like hanging upside down. I said, you know what I call them? So do you know what I call these bats on a tree?
Bats? No. Okay.
Bat tree.
Chandan, are you happy? Chandan, you should be happy. Okay.
You asked for
some
it.
Of my brain cells committed suicide. Some of my brain cells said, okay, no more.
Oh, God. Yeah. So, battery. So, I had come up with that and I actually took a video of it. I said, you know, I actually have a few more up my sleeve, but I'll probably figure that out later. Yeah.
Hi, my sister is here.
Hi. So full, good to see you.
Full family scene going on, huh?
yeah. Indian feed. Okay, Hindi. Ask a question.
We both will answer. Why don't you all go for and let's see, come up with witty questions.
Oh, gosh. We're still not on live. Okay. All the sisters are in. Thank you for all the lovely compliments, people. So sweet of you. So it's really nice. Okay. So rapid fire. I mean, I don't know. It could be anything. Like, but I want to know, especially about your, I'm sure, I mean, I don't know. Are there more guys here or girls here? Because I want to ask you the secret to your beautiful skin, actually.
The secret to my beautiful skin? I drink a lot of warm water. It's going to get so boring. I drink a lot of cinnamon water, green tea, and I religiously apply coconut oil. That's all.
Okay, that's good. I think that's a great tip for everybody. Not just girls, it's for guys. Okay.
The first name, place, animal, thing that comes to your mind. With which alphabet? Okay,
I'm going to give you an alphabet. H. With H, place, animal, thing.
A-H. Hridoy is the name. Place, Haridwar.
Okay.
That's a long name. Name, place, animal. Horse, thing is hat. Now you go with it.
Did you say name of a place?
Haridwar.
Ah, yes. Okay, not bad. Okay. All right, so give me an alphabet. Don't make it tough.
H. Go for it. H.
Okay. Harry.
Okay.
Name, place, Holland. Animals can be Hasta Manana.
Animal with H, man. What is it?
A hyena. Thing is, so many things are there.
There is.
There are many things. I can't believe I got them all and put things are stuck. Okay, house.
Okay. Yeah, why not?
Oh gosh, oh gosh.
Indian people enjoying this. We are glad to...
Correct. Oh God. Yeah. This is so funny. All right. Oh, one more round and then... So, okay, I'm giving you one more alphabet. Okay, the alphabet is R.
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 Name.
Thank you, Angie.
Rina.
Okay.
Rina is name. Okay, places. R. Shit, what place? R. Rajasthan, huh?
Okay.
Name, place, animal. Rat. Thing is.
Hey, Sheldon. Welcome. Good to see you here. Bolo.
Ruler. Ruler.
I have all night. I'm in quarantine. I have all night. You can take your time. No problem.
Ruler. I'm done.
Oh, God. Okay. And my alphabet?
R.
You copycat? Copycat. Okay. Chalo. Hi. Okay. R. Say Romeo.
Okay.
Okay. Name, place, Rome. So Romeo went to Rome. Okay. Name, place, animal is, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
What? No.
Reindeer. Hello. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. It's still with R.
Okay.
Okay. Reindeer. Okay. Name, place, animal, thing. Okay, is a thing can be, why do I get stuck with a damn thing? Okay, R is Rumal.
Please.
Please. Okay. R can be a rock. Okay, all right. So, theek hai? All right. Okay, Chandan is asking, what is acting? What is acting to you, Anna?
What is acting to me?
Yes.
Oh, that's very simple. Acting is life.
Okay, sorry.
Rope. Samrat is saying rope. They are coming with so many things now.
Okay, what is acting for you?
Acting is life. Acting is like breathing. I don't think I can differentiate my passion from who I am. So acting is everything. Acting is... really everything, literally everything for me. Acting was not there, then I wouldn't be there. So yeah.
In fact, I remember, again, when you, you were doing a play, a theater.
Yeah.
And I remember how you wrote every single dialogue in Hindi in your diary. And I remember I was guinea pigs to practice, and I was like, can I get out of this room? I don't know how you did it. And when I saw you on stage, all your hard work, you were amazing. So
Chandan,
it was amazing.
Live life then?
How do you live life then? Matlab, yeah. We live life. Oh, craft.
I mean. Okay, craft. Okay. So that's how he means. Okay. Craft, I think you, like everything else, you got to do riyaz every day. You have to sharpen your knife every day. It's like that. So that can be anything. Every actor has a different way. Some people do nothing. Some people are spontaneous. Some people... So for me, I can individually, like for me... I think I like reading and gathering a lot of information about what I'm doing and then try and see how I can amalgamate it in life through, like, whether that works for me or whether that doesn't work for me. Like, I'm a mixture of method and spontaneity. I don't like doing too much of anything. I like a balance because that's what works for me. May not work for somebody, but works for me. Yeah.
With me, it's very different. I am a directors actor. So I've not gone to any acting school. I've not trained anywhere. And all I know is I bring my life experience, from wherever I can, whatever I can bring my life experience on the screen. So it just happens. I just tend to adapt because the minute the director is just talking to me and I'm like, okay, I'm getting it, I'm getting it. So half your battle is won in if you're able to pull off the look of the character, So and you've played many roles, of late, especially with Hostage, and you've played many roles. So what happens is the minute you're in character, the look is half your one. The rest is, of course, what you bring to the table. And our director, I totally trust my directors. And the more we surrender and trust our directors, we're able to get their vision out as and with the combination of. So I just land up on set. I just land up on set, and the next thing is, now let's take it forward, and what needs to be done. Yeah, that's my method, which is not much of a method.
No, I think if it works for you, it's a very personal thing. So if it works for you, it's for you. Like when I was working in Hostage, like Sudhir Mishra, he does not like giving any direction.
Oh,
Like
really?
Sudhir sir, just say action and go.
Okay.
It's up to you. So in the first time, I was baffled. I'm like, "Arey, but he's not saying anything."
Oh,
But then
God.
you get you, and then you're like, okay. You have to be that prepared. You have to be that much in your character to know he will not say anything. He will not give you directions. He will not.
But it also shows that he trusts you for bringing your best out there. That's what it shows, that he trusts you enough to bring what you can. And I think that's a big compliment,
And he's very cool. He is the coolest director that I've worked with. He's so composed. He doesn't shout and throw attitude on set, which I have had a bit of also. But he
Like he
is.
says, yeah, it says that it is spontaneous method. And in a way that's right, because as actors, when we do the same scene, like cut after cut after cut, can the magic of the movie can just go. But I think step to something like this where you're spontaneous, I think it brings out the element that needs to be captured, I guess.
True, true,
Yeah.
true. Yeah, and so Chandan, guys, Chandan is both of our common friends. So it's not like Khelia and all that is. We know him for years.
For
So
years.
yeah, please
We all have been
put that.
actors for many years, so yeah. That's
And
why.
so this our
In fact,
favorite.
Chandan has been my co-actor in a couple of in couple of things we've acted. So we did something called Women's Safety Begins at Home, where we talk about domestic violence. And Chandan was my co-actor in that film. And I think you all should watch it. If everybody out there, please watch Women's Safety Begins at Home. It's a very important message about being a role model and treating each other. So please watch it. It's a very, very profound message. So Chandan has been my.
Angie says we are still young though. Yes, Angie. True.
Okay, so oh my gosh, Gana Sunado. Now,
This time now, Chrissy, you चलो 1 2 3 play.
okay, song. Oh, okay, let's see. Okay, one. What's my favorite? नीले अंबर पर चांद जब छाए प्यार बरसाए हमको तरसाए ऐसा कोई साथी हो. Oh my gosh, I can't sing high. ऐसा कोई प्रेमी हो प्यास दिल की जाए नीले अंबर पर. ओके बस.
पिटेगा वो. चंदन इज सिंग सेक्सी गाना सुनाओ. सेक्सी गाना
What
क्या होता है चंदन?
nonsense!
व्हाट इज सेक्सी गाना?
नॉनसेंस
हाँ
यार कुछ भी, आई डोंट नो एनी सेक्सी सॉन्ग प्लीज।